Oh, he's so much. Yet.
Beautiful. Tight him again. Beautiful. That actually let him become a little bit rounder. Beautiful. You like the feeling? So leg him a little bit there when he gets a little bit low. And you have to sit a little bit more upright. If he gets a little low, look at the ceiling. Sit more uphill. Look at the ceiling there. It doesn't matter. Different feeling. You gotta learn the feeling with him. One more hand. Look up. Yeah. When he goes low, you go high with your upper body. You're sitting upright. Very good. Keep your inner leg working a little bit in the rhythm of the canter.
Mm-hmm. It's so just not feeling it.
One more circle. And you've got to keep more weight in your outside foot and a little bit more driving inner leg. Keep a little bit more elastic strength. Good. There you go. Now canter onto the diagonal. Right your canter. Don't be afraid of making it a little bigger. That's your canter. And let it drop. There you go. Slow the trot down a little bit for me. Bring him to the point you could walk, but don't walk. Half halt. Use your back like you did earlier. Squish your elbows into another half halt. Yeah, and push him back to the rail so that you have a connection from your inner leg. Awesome. Now bring him back again so he doesn't get to lean on the rein. And now find that giving point. And now between A and F, hand your left foot. Getting confidence to ride the canter more forward within the collection. Very good. Sit towards the corner, around shot away when you hit, and don't be afraid to make those short steps a little bit, play with them a little bit. And just keep in mind, he will give a little buck up sometimes, you know, just be aware. Feeling that you would trot out of it. That's a really good start. Okay. Good job. Really dropping. Good. Stay back with your seat. Good. And just feel out that canter. Make it feel the way you want it to feel. Good. Well, you can start to, you don't have to use your imagination of where the canter pirouette would be now,
oh,
right?
Totally.
Yeah.
Nice.
Good. You just keep that seat of yours. There. Good. Really good.
Yeah, you're good.
Just hold the round button in for a couple of seconds.
Just washing my hands. You know, it's kind of where you get home from anything. And like even like, you know, speaking about going to the grocery store, like
yeah.
touching the carts and stuff, I always wash my hands after that.
Excellent. How's it feeling up there?
You try not to be paranoid, but at the same time, aware.
Good. And you're feeling good up there? So I'm going to help you with the warm-up today. You know, it's going to be a little bit of a different feeling because you haven't warmed him up yourself. But you have watched us warming him up a lot lately. It seemed like we're really sort of focused on getting him stretching and long in the beginning. And I see you're able to do that really well in the walk. Before we get started, though, I want to ask if there's anything you want me to clarify or anything that you really want me to specifically help you with today. Do you have any thoughts or questions or concerns before we start? I want you to have the information that you want to have.
Well, it's an evasive question I'm going to answer. How do I know when? How do I know when the trot is the right trot, or the walk is the right walk? And because we're constantly, I'm just not clear on that. And that's probably not just this portion, so it's not here to ask you, but when you say something,
that's a good question. It's a really good question. How do I know when it's right, basically,
yeah,
if it's the right trot or the right walk? For me, I like to think of things being the right trot is when you have total control in it and that you have the ability to relax on the trot that you've created and you're able to maintain that trot without having to maintain it. It's a little bit like the feeling of you put your car on cruise control. And it's the same feeling in the trot or the walk or the canter that you might have to use your body and your back and your seat and your rein to create a shape or a speed or a balance. But then you should be able to sit neutral on that feeling and he maintains that and that's when I know it's right. Does that make sense?
Yes, I want to feel that time. It might take 2 weeks, but I want you to tell me so I can recognize
I will.
Yeah,
and I.
Him.
And I want you to know that in the training, when we're training these horses, we might get a trot that's really nice, and I'm really going to enjoy that trot myself, but then my job as a trainer is to check, can I modify this trot? Can I modify something about this trot without losing control of all these other aspects that I've created? That's what makes these horses feel really good, that we can independently change or control or modify one aspect, and they maintain control of all of the others. For example, you're in this beautiful collective trot, I want you to make the tempo of the trot quicker. But I don't want to make the strides longer, and I don't
right.
want the neck to get lower, and I don't want the contact to get stronger. That's when we know it's right, when we have all of these aspects. And every horse is a little bit different. You know, Donna was harder to get in the self-carriage and the balance in the canter. Or this horse might be a little bit harder to get the suspension in the trot at this point in his life. You know, and it's an ever-evolving thing. What I like about the trot today, in 6 months, it's not going to be good enough, you know? We're going to expect more, we're going to expect an evolution. That's a very, very good question that I didn't really answer, but I hope it makes you understand that.
I need a visual, I just want
that kind of person. No, I get that,
okay,
I get that.
I all of a sudden decide to do something new here. And I should have have already have been in a place where I could do anything from that place, sort of, right? Is that the
yes.
way it sounds?
Yeah, you, what you need to think about is you get ready for a transition. I stay ready for a transition. That's how I, yeah.
Like
you don't have to get ready when you stay ready. That's for you. And that's what a real collected walk is, a walk that you could halt from or trot from. A real collected canter you could halt from or extend from. And that's what real collection is. It means that it's ready for anything. Most people think collection is, oh, my horse is just really short and it's stride right now. It's compressed, but it's ready for something. And I want you to think about, as you're riding around in the walk here, I want you to think, Nicholas might ask me to trot, or he might ask me to halt. And I want to walk this way for both of those things. And that's when we have the right. Does that make sense? So walk up alongside, and just think in your mind, I'm either going to ask you to trot or halt. Try to have both of those things in your mind.
Yeah.
Halt for me. The halt itself is pretty good. You just need to keep the neck a little bit softer within it. And that's you being a little bit braver to play on the reins within the halt. Does that make sense? Good. And now walk on again. And just show me a good medium walk that's ready for anything. And show me that you can trot. Good. And that tells me that sort of anything's available. So that's going to be your barometer, right? That's going to be you knowing when you have the right trot that this is giving you. That your post can dictate the rhythm. Don't just ride to this rhythm. Good. And I want you to let his neck go down there a little bit. Give him that room in front. Trust him a little bit more. Let him have the reins a little bit. Let him get that out of his system so that his muscles can get warm. Let him know that there is freedom for him to carry his neck himself. Now, if you keep contact always, he will need contact always, and he will look for that support, and then he'll be a stronger horse than you want him to be. And I would say that's kind of what probably happened to Donner in his younger years, that he was allowed to lean on a bit, and then he decided he needed to lean on a bit, and then it took a long time to teach him that he didn't have to lean on a bit. You don't need to make this horse like that. He's this blank slate that you can make him feel exactly the way you want him to feel. So I actually want you to allow your reins to become a little longer. Give him his neck. Now, if he speeds up, that's on him. That's his mistake, not yours. If he speeds up, then we'll sort that out. But I sometimes think you're riding a little bit reactive to him and trying to get him perfect. Let him make a mistake, and then you can make a correction. Let the neck open in. Beautiful. That's what I want to see in the beginning. That's ideal. Warming up trot and frame for me and the rhythm. Super job. Going to make a 20-meter circle at sea. Good, and just look on the line of the circle. Daniela on the grey horse sees you. Well done, very good. And you just turn your body a little left. How's the feeling in that? I want you to relax your upper arms a little bit more. Try so hard, that's it. Good, and now change rein on the long diagonal. Upper arms loose, you've got too much tension in them. Let them just hang. Your legs just hang off your hips beautifully. Let your arms just hang off your shoulders. Let your elbows just sit in against your waist. Bend your elbows. Yeah. The forearm is an extension of the rein. And your elbows create that tension on the bridle. Good. And a 20-meter circle up here when you're ready. Think about those elbows being more by your side. There you go. You can really control your body, and then we're able to really control his. He's carrying not just himself, but you as well. So let's carry yourself in a nice square symmetrical way. That's better. Good, and now trot large and try to keep your inside shoulder upright in the corner, that you don't lean into the corner. There you go. Now look in the mirror when you can and just see that your body looks a little bit more square, and then your elbows hug your torso a little more. Better. Good. And you see when you're giving the rein, he's actually not speeding up. He's not changing the rhythm, right? Very often if you hang on to them, it makes them want to go more and more and more, and then you give the rein and they realize, oh, I don't have to pull on you because I've got that freedom. Very often horses pulling on the rein is just the horse telling the rider, hey, I need a bit more space in front. Gorgeous, I love that. Super nice. Very good. Just going to keep your elbows tucked in against your side without pulling back. And you're going to make a three-loop serpentine from A, but this is the way I want you to start. Just let him have room in front. bigger stud to warm up this morning. I want you to feel more weight in your outside foot when you're turning. So this is going to be your right foot right now. See, now you're perfectly square, and you see he didn't fall in on that circle. Yeah, and now as you cross the center line, step to the left and look over the side of his left neck. See how much better that last figure was to the right? There you go. Now you just fell a little bit onto your right foot again. Outside foot. There. Do the three loops again. Tiny little bit shorter with your right inner range. You're just dropping your inner shoulder a little. There you go. It's alright. It's alright, but you made a little bit of a rapid adjustment, so he sped up, right?
No, he can hear you.
So you have to start to think about making the adjustments in your own body a little bit steadier.
I know, I was just thinking that.
Ride that one more time and make sure we get three loops, not four. There you go. That's it. Slow your post down. If he feels like it's becoming too quick, slow your post down. Very good. Your spine over his spine. Your chin in line with his wither. That's it. Your chin in line with his wither. Good. Step into your outer stirrup and keep your chin in. Perfect correction there. I can see you made a little self-adjustment there. That was ideal. Chin in line with the wither. Step into your outer stirrup. So much better. Do you feel the difference on that? Very good. And now you can come a little bit to the inside track. Sitting trot, and we'll shorten our reins. Keep your chin in line with the wither, that you don't turn your body too much left. Good. And now let's sit back and make a walk transition without relying on your reins. Use your back and your weight. Let's do it one more time, because it could be even a little easier than that, right? If it wasn't perfect, just do it again and finesse it. See, there you were able to just let him walk rather than sort of make him walk, right? Very good. Is this helping you understand more about how to create that correct feeling? Driving, sort of used to being behind the horse and seeing everything from behind, and now I want you a little bit more in the middle of the horse. And when you're behind the horse, you can make the correction after the fact, and when you're on the horse, you have to make it in the moment, right? So that just means we've got to get you off your 2 second delay. It's mean you're thinking a little bit more to make you more reactive to your balance. There you're sitting so square that have no notes. So much better. Very good. Super. Very good. And for me, that's the ideal frame for him at the moment, because you can give on the reins, you can keep your seat, and everything stays the same. Very nice. Let's make left shoulder four up the long side. All you have to do is close your inner leg to your outer range. You can turn your body a little bit on the axis of your own spine. Perfect. Good. And look in the mirror and enjoy what you just created. And now just show us all how beautiful the self-carriage is by giving on the reins. And nothing really changed, right? He even became a little bit rounder, and there was nothing wrong with that. That was beautiful. Very good. Now I want to see you trot up the quarter line after C, and we make leg yielding away from our left inside leg. It's the same age as the shoulder, and it's just you're pointing him in a different direction. Very good, and stay back on your seat. Excellent, and now you just have to bend your right knee a little bit more. Good job, just so that he doesn't run through the gate too much there. Good, now we're going to ride shoulder in. So that's just shoulder forward, but with more angle, when you get him to 30 degrees from that white rail. So start flexing him a little bit in the corner. Close your inner leg that he's accepting that. Feel your outer rein. And you should be able to see three of his legs in the mirror. Good. How many do you see? Yeah, that looks, from here, looks about perfect. Very good. Yeah, so if you've got four, it just means you've got a fraction too much angle. I'd rather you be able to find too much angle than not enough, though. Good, and now let's do it again without the mirror. And let's see if your feeling is as good as your visual. I know you think it's not, but I think it is. I want you to come around again, and I want you to take the track this time. Realize that he's just a little bit looking at that golf cart next door. I want you to use the corner to help set up the figure more. Good. Good. Don't need more angle. That's ideal. Very good. Now put a tiny bit more weight in your right foot. There you go. Then you won't leave the rail.
One thing we talked about was that riding
right. Can you hear what Andrew's saying? We're talking about what movement we're riding right now is shoulder in, right? And every time you're riding up the long side, you're using the outer rein and the inner leg to bring the forehand to the left. Your inner leg is back a little bit, but it's truly your outside rein that's bringing the forehand over. You're absolutely moving the chest, yes. And the reason that I'm so fussy about your outside leg is because if it's not there, then the haunches are just going to fall out. You have a horse that, but you know, I really want you to know that you could ride the shoulder in off the track as well. So why don't we do a half 10 at E, and then you're going to trot up the center line and shoulder in, and then you're going to really understand the importance of your outer leg as much as your inner leg. And even though you're putting your left leg on, your right leg should still be further back.
Yeah.
There you go. That was well done. A little bit outside weight. Yeah. Very good. Very good. You can go right. Just change the rein and go the other direction. I didn't give you very much time. Don't worry about that. It's not a big deal. And now we're going to work the right shoulder forward. So show me a subtle shoulder in. You don't even need your right leg further back than that. You just need to hit his tummy a little bit. And I want you to soften your outer rein a little bit more to allow him to be a little bit more flexed. Do you feel that?
I don't.
There you go. Something's
got
to give. You know? Yeah, exactly. If you don't soften the outer rein, his neck just becomes shorter and shorter. That was good. And now we ride on the long side, shoulder in. And I want you to ride on the rail, not relying on the rail. Ride as though the rail is there. I'll spend days with my horses just riding on the inside track. For me, you have him too straight down the left side. I love that you're able to do that, but I want to see you soften your left rein and add a little bit more right leg and put your left leg back a little bit. Put your left leg back a little bit. Yeah, because for me, the left side of his body should be longer than the right side. Does that make sense? Yeah, and yes, and because you had a little bit of a heavy inside seat bone and you didn't have enough weight on that outside seat bone. Now let's just do that again. Just think 10 degrees more weight on your left seat bone. There's a scale under your left seat bone. Sit on it a little bit more. Go ahead and lift up your inner hand a little bit and lower your outer hand, and there's the flexion. Now the horse is longer on the left and shorter on the right. Beautiful. Super job. Very good. And now you can turn up the trot a little bit. Make a little more impulse in the trot. That's the one. Good. And now do the same thing up the snaffle. Just to lift the snaffle a little bit up in the roof of his mouth. And then you'll keep that right ear up. And then that will make you keep your left hand down. And now show me without touching the rein so you can make a walk transition.
The two direct leg
and use your
weight
on the rein. Which is
sure good.
Good.
Very, very good.
Stand for that now. Very good.
And you've got to trot away.
Super
and
job.
Can I ask a big favor? Can someone make me a coffee, please?
Is it coffee?
Well, yeah, but it's good. Like a little bit more milk. Still being conscious of that weight on your straight left shoulder, right? You're going to track left towards us.
That's it.
Bye, Donna. I'll see you later. Thank you.
You don't need any shorter
Thanks
rein
a lot.
Than that now.
No, I won't. Right. Otherwise, you don't have rein, but I think sometimes we need to give up on a little bit sometimes so that when we do use it, it can be heard.
Say that again, sorry.
Let's go for more forward in the trot. Be a little ambitious now. Think about the horses the way you saw them trotting yesterday and just build a little bit towards that. And now feel, can I still make a walk transition on my back? So now you're starting to understand about not pushing the horse more than we can control, right? Because I told you to push him, you did, and then you realize, oh, I can't really make a walk transition as easily as I could earlier. So for me, that's some information for you in that. Good, eyes up. There, that was better. Good job. And now trot up alongside and use your decision-making process of how much you can develop a tribe beyond, without developing it beyond your level of control, yeah? And I think that's pretty good. The mouth is really quiet. That looks really nice. You like the feeling? Good. So now let's make a 20-meter circle and we'll bring that towards the canter. And you're going to go with this canter. It's going to be a little bit different than the trot. The canter, I want you to ride it, allow him to go a little bit more. I want you to ride the canter forwards first, and then we can start to bring it back a little bit later. Good. And you really have to think about your left seat bone and your left shoulders. Yeah. There you go. You self-corrected before I could finish it. I love that. And just see the outside of the neck, but it stays on the circle. Eyeball the left shoulder. Eyeball. That's a different thought, huh? Now you're steering the left side of his body as much as the right side. Good. And just stay on that circle. And if you cannot see that left shoulder, if it's not within your line of vision, then it's not on the line of the circle. And it means you're probably falling to the right. Eyeball it, right here. Exactly, that's gonna help keep you centered. Good, and I don't wanna be riding around looking down, but at the moment, it's fine for you to do that, to check your center. It doesn't matter. Who cares? That's it. Good. About what you did with your two hands in the shoulder, and you lifted one up, you put the other one down. That makes a bit of a difference. That's it. And now think about the elasticity in your elbows. Think about what the rhythm of the canter is. The canter, and your elbows should have a little give and take. Left hand stays down, but still think about that little circular elasticity through your elbows, the give and take. Doing great. Good. And now you can see the outside shoulder because you're in the middle. You're in the middle the whole time. Good. And now you start to understand how complex a circle is, right? Yeah. Good. And now take him large and suddenly things will be a lot easier. But you know, to ride a correct circle is really difficult. Well done. Teach me on Fiero. I just rode a Grand Prix with him yesterday. He will tear me to shreds on just the way I ride a circle. Has to be correct. Good. There you go. Has to be turning off the outside rein. And you're doing it really well there. Good. Put a little bit more inner leg on there without leaving the track. There you go. Now you have him on two reins. Very good. Now try to keep that feeling on the circle. You're going to eyeball the left shoulder, but you're going to feel that pocket for your inside leg. Left shoulder, inside leg. Yes. There. That was really good on the second part of the circle where you cross the center line. Inside leg, outside shoulder. Good. That's the direction of pressure on your reins. Super riding, super. I don't mind when that happens at all because you sat really quiet and it's his job to keep cantering. He just sometimes gets a little bit surprised when you sit quiet. And he just misinterpreted you there. And you just make the correction in that moment and say, actually, buddy, I want you to keep going. There you go. Now you go large and you find your way to the trot again. Very good riding. Now you're finding that connection. And just exhale and let him trot. Not on your reins, on your back. Let it take a little while. It's okay if it takes a little while. Thank you so much. Good. And now shoulder for him so that he doesn't run through you too much. Turn your right shoulder back. Now put you back into it. Perseo, get back here. Thank you, then be sweet. There you go. That's it. He just took you for a bit of a ride up that long side. Do shoulder in again, that's where you're gonna gain the control. Outside seat bone. Yeah. There you go. See, now you're suddenly in total control again, right? Good, and walk again. I don't know who told me this, and I was probably way too young to hear it, but a trainer once told me that shoulder in is like Valium for the horse. You know, it just calms them down. It just really brings them into this calm place. And I was probably 13 when I heard that, and didn't even know what Valium was. But it makes sense, right? No, it really suits. Good. That was way before safe sport. Good job. Start to feel when you had a pocket for your inner leg and that, you know, eyeballing that outside shoulder, right? Yeah. Think about,
Have you ever watched a, you know, like a speed class in show jumping when they're doing the jump off and they're going as fast as they can? And a horse lands from a fence and they have to do a really tight U-turn. They're not bent to the inside, are they? They bend them to the outside and they turn them off the outside rein. That's, we want to be a bit more sophisticated than that in dressage, but we're really still turning the horse from the outside rein rather than the inside rein. I want you to just let him walk a little bit with long reins again. But I want... I don't think you need to be excited about warming up for me. I think you need to be excited about having a horse that I absolutely love training, having a horse that I will give back but that I don't want to. I would love to keep this horse, but I also get so much joy about how beautifully you ride him. And I think Andrea should get a little bit of credit too, about creating a horse that I love riding.
In a show, focus the
day.
And now drop the reins just to prove to us how beautiful the self carriage is. Love it. But that's you on your back riding into a giving rein. When you're asking if that's the right trot, that's the right trot. Yeah. Does it feel nice to you? Usually, if things feel really nice, that's usually right.
Trust yourself.
If this feels awful, you tell me, and it's probably wrong. That's it. Good. Circle for me when you're ready.
Yeah, you never get that great.
Yeah.
And when you find the right sort of window on the circle, you just close your inner leg, take your outer leg back, and you can turn left for me. Just be ready to go with the momentum. I think you went too much with the momentum. I felt like you threw your body forward, and I want you to ask and be a little bit more patient for the canter to happen under your seat. Try it again. And don't look at that as a mistake, look at that as an opportunity to understand what the perfect aid is. Good, and you're just going to eyeball the right shoulder, just like you did. Sort of things fall into place a little bit better for you this way. Good. I'm the opposite. I'm a better right canterer than left canterer. So between us, I think we'll get it done. Good.
You're left-handed. I'm better than right.
I'm not left-handed. I'm not left-handed, but I write... No.
Yeah.
No, I'm not. In gymnastics, I am, I think.
So in everything but actually riding, you're probably...
So whatever hand you are, typically people ride better that direction?
I don't know if that's the case, but usually people ride one canter better than the other.
Gotcha.
And Martha's really
I like the left better, and I'm left-handed.
Just feel it out. Now what I want you to think about is where your circle belongs, okay? So that circle was a little wide.
Because I need to get otherwise.
And just think about you're in the round pen. You know, there's no corners, it's consistent. Amount of turning all the way around, a consistent amount all the way around to your body on the left. You got it. But that was a little smaller. As you cross the center line, you should be just like 4 or 5 feet on the right side of R. Right side of R. A little more jump. It's a sweet canter, but it's a little passive. Right, a little bit more impulsion. Now look for R. Look for it and be on the right side of it. Just on the right as you cross the center line. That's a 20-meter circle. That's a 20-meter circle there. Good. Better. Do it one more time.
That's what I like.
Very
I
good.
Do beach body.
Super job. Think everything just works now, huh? Very good. You're going to finish your circle,
right,
and you're going to take it large.
Right,
keep a little bit more bend in your outside knee.
And you're like, you know what, my chin
hands forward.
Right, exactly.
You do the work for Sayo. I'm going to keep my seat active, but I'm not going to keep the canter with my hands. I'm going
to
keep it with my seat and my leg. Good, let him cover a little more ground. I can sort of see that brewing a little bit. He got a little distracted.
Everybody's talking and I'm like,
and I want you to just think about the correction is always impulsion, right? Good correction there. And just make sit a little bit more with your shoulders over your hips, not behind them. Sit a little bit like you're going to lean forward, like you're going to jump a fence. There you go. That's upright now, okay? Yeah, use your back when you need it, but don't use it when you want to ride forward. The back is more of a waiting aid. Now follow with your seat. Just bring your shoulders to the wither a little bit. Sit a little forward. Now close your legs. That's your canter.
Have your seat arm together, your upper body back.
Exactly. Very good. Super. Change right onto the diagonal. Let him trot. And I want you to ride the right canter again. Because you rode that left so well. And I just want you to feel out what you did. And just bring it to the right canter.
Good.
A little bit straighter in the neck. I felt like you picked up the right canter with a little bit of left flexion. So Just see the left shoulder again, remember? That's it. See the left shoulder. Stay large. Sit a little bit, feeling like you're sitting forwards. Feel like you're sitting forwards. Good. You're going to see on the video right now that you're not sitting forwards. You're sitting directly upright. Good. Yeah, but now you've mastered that. That's done. You don't need to do it anymore. And if you do it all the time, it loses its effect. Try not to keep them in candle with your reins. More with your leg. More with your inside leg. Push him back to the fence and soften your inside rein. Yeah, now you're letting him canter better. Push him into the corner with your inside leg, but see the left shoulder. That's a better corner. There you go. Push him into the corner. That's a better corner. Very good. And now we let him trot again. Just close your knees. Good. Shoulder for him. Shoulder for him. Yeah, sometimes he takes you having to put your back into it a little bit like that, and then you'll be sweet again. Next time, I want you to make your half hop twice as strong, but for half the amount of time you fell a little right in that corner. Now get her done, get in and out. Straight again. Straight again. Side leg. Thank you. Let go of the outside rein. That's why he runs a little bit fast, I feel, because sometimes he feels a little bit like he's being held back. Good. So you're going to go to the trot. Give the rein before you take the rein in the transition. And trot. And now be nice. And now make another one. And now be nice. There you go. That's it. And now if you do that one more time but in shoulder four in the trot, then it will totally work for you. Because that's really going to make you pair up your diagonal aids. So put your body in shoulder four. Left seat bone. Left seat bone. Left seat bone. Thank you. Now right shoulder four. See, now you don't even have to make your half hold. It was through the shoulder forward that you soothed him again, right? Valium, huh?
Xanax.
There you go. Let him out on the left side. There you go. Otherwise, you're riding a little bit ronvia, right, but bend to the left. And that just tells me that he gets a little bit tight, or you get a little bit tight on the left rein. Now let's go rising and let's stretch him down there. And I think, to be perfectly honest, you did such a nice job with him today that I don't think he needs me to ride him.
Thank you.
No, I think I want to be fair. My pleasure. I want to be fair to him, and I think I honestly really feel like you rode him so clearly and in such a fair way that he used his body really nicely. And I do 3 days work and then a light day and then a couple of days and then a light day, and I think that was good. And you didn't work him that light. You worked him well, but it wasn't too much pressure. It's very good. Let him stretch this way. Good work. You've got to be the first one to give on the rein with him. You know, he won't always offer it first. Sometimes you give first and then he realizes, oh, I don't need to run. There I have room in front. Good. And now show me without relying on your reins in any way that you can. Job. You made some really good
cover, like, you can see the mirrors better without a sun.
Uh-huh. doing my job. Thank you.
Fine.
Inside.
without looking, you can see the right eyelashes, right? Like without leaning to look. There you go, I love that. This is good. And now the rhythm is so nice. And you're going to trot large again. Very good. Super. Let's just position him a little bit in right shoulder four. Just slow your rise down a little bit that he doesn't get too much momentum in the trot. I love how ambitious he is.
Oops.
Sorry.
Sorry, Martha.
Sorry, Martha.
I keep getting off of it.
Still on the circle, still turning off the outer rein, but that's really, really nice.
Oops.
Very good. You're going to go large. You're going to right, left shoulder.
Yes, that is good.
Square shoulders.
Oh, shoot. Where'd she go? Oh.
Meter circle now. Return to the shoulder in. I want the shoulder in this time to have a little bit more angle. 30
that's what I miss about Ken.
I wasn't built like, I would never go to a
reliable in the camera now. Good.
super, super correction. Very good. Now, when you ride the next corner, see the outside shoulder and be a little bit more dominant with your left leg. Good. Left leg and outside shoulder visible. Good riding. Good riding. Good riding. Well done. When you're ready, you let him trot. Right.